So, firstly, what Somethin Else is doing from our vision department
is making programming.
That's good, is it? Good. We're making programming where the audience is directly a collaborator, such as a cross-platform drama that we're developing with the BBC called Our Life, which won one of the categories at the Content 360 competition in Cannes this year. It's designed to get the best out of a community in the terms of a drama, combining the best of a community with the best of seasoned dramatists, which has some inherent, very interesting challenges that we think we've solved. The challenges are twofold when you invite audiences to become developers or co-creators. There's this value question, because when people collaborate with social media, the value, what they're trying to create, is different to normal sort of us and them kind of media. You can think of the value of watching a bit of video on YouTube. It might be jittery and stuttery, but the point is that it's social, it's a shared piece of media. And this means that old school broadcasting people sometimes really suffer. They really don't quite get this. The joy of drama comes from the surprise and sort of confounded expectation. And again, that's a very tricky thing to achieve if you're bringing the audience in to collaborate on a narrative in a drama. So these are some of the things that we've been really trying to address with Our Life. And one of the ways that we did this was by publishing the narrative arc. You can tell exactly what's going to happen at 12 different points along the narrative of the drama. But exactly what those things are is up for speculation, it's up for doubt, it's up for collaboration. So we tell the audience many elements of what it is that we're doing. We collaborate on filling in some of the gaps. And then just before broadcast, we re-script, we reshoot, and we create the program together. So all the surprises there, but all the social elements of collaborative media are also there. We're also working on involving audiences in our work in console gaming. We're very focused on social gaming there. One of the main things that we've done that people in this conference will probably know about is working on a series called Buzz, which is a PlayStation 2 game franchise that comes with these four big red buzzers that you buzz in on. And up to four of you at the moment in the PlayStation 2 game are able to play at the same time against each other. It's sort of set in a TV game show. And the game is all about the gameplay, it's all about the audio, and we create these games together with Relentless in Brighton. The point about this is that we're creating narratives, we're creating an interactive, story-based experience that's only possible to appreciate through the agency of a live audience. It creates itself from second to second in concert with an audience. This is something that broadcasting just can't do. The future of this sort of media is extremely interesting. Can't talk about the plans for Buzz, but what we can say is that we know that both PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360 are exploring ways of releasing periodic episodic gaming title, which is created in exactly the same way that a TV or a radio program would be, very, very close to broadcast, but being inherently interactive. It's a fascinating class of interactive entertainment. And then finally, there's also a whole class of televisual programming which we're creating, which combines elements of gameplay with elements of television or radio. Again, the fact that spectrum is no longer a constraining condition, a constraining thought when you're creating broadcast programming. You've got broadband, you've got the internet. And also cheap cameras or, you know, Skype telephony means that live broadcasting can have social forms, which is something that so far hasn't been explored yet. And this is where the fun is. To give an example of this, I'd recommend people look at a site out of Holland called Super Dudes and Sugar Babes, SUPERDUDES.NL. But it's a kind of a competitive TV program where the audience competes to become the presenter. But they pay for themselves, they pay for adverts on the website for why people should vote for them. That's a very crude example of I'm not a celebrity, get me in there kind of programming, which is now permitted by engaging with your audience as a developer. So just a very quick sketched out snapshot of some of the things that were interesting and we're interested in. Thanks.
Thank you, Paul. Okay, we're going